high above the Amazon basin, hidden amongst the clouds. The most destructive disease ever known to science is raging through the environment, killing thousands and leaving a trail of extinction in its wake. While these worlds are largely isolated from the rest of civilization, the future of these inverse islands are in jeopardy and are where some of the world's rarest and most important creatures live. While many of them have already been lost for eternity, it is believed that survivors remain that might possess a cure to ending this devastating pandemic. But without active preservation, we might lose their secrets as well. With time quickly running out, we will join a scientific mission and brave into these mysterious places in an attempt to discover this holy grail of the Amazon before it's too late.
Oh, I think I got one.
Really?
Got it.
Yeah, that's
Is this
the
it?
One. Yeah, that's the one.
Woo!
Our journey begins in Quito, Ecuador, at Jambatu, a world-renowned amphibian research center. The scientists here study hundreds of endangered species of frogs and toads in an effort to solve everything from extinction of species to advanced medical science surrounding frog toxins. This is where we are meeting up with Dr. Lena Valencia, a conservation scientist with rewild.org that is leading our research mission into the wilds of the Amazon slopes. But first, we need to understand what exactly we will be searching for.
Lena, what a room. This is so cool. What do you have here?
Look at this beautiful harlequin toad.
Wow, it is gorgeous.
Look at these jewels of the forest of South and Central America. Look at
this is a harlequin toad.
Yep.
Is it a toad or is it a frog? Because, I mean, to me, we filmed poison frogs. It looks a lot like a frog.
It is colorful like a poison frog, but it's a toad.
It's a toad. What a beautiful amphibian. Do you mind if, can
no,
I hold
go
one too?
For it.
Very gentle.
They're sadly one of the most endangered groups of amphibians. Most of them are threatened or endangered by a deadly infectious disease. It's a fungus that it's like a pandemic that is wiping populations of harlequin toads and other amphibian species everywhere in the world.
This fungus, tell me a little bit more about it.
So amphibians and frogs, harlequin toads, they breathe through their skin. And this fungus, what basically does is they cause heart attack that instantly kills these toads.
Right now, we're at Jambatu, which is one of the world's biggest amphibian research centers. And what are they doing to try to preserve this species from extinction?
What they're doing here in Jambatu is to reproduce them and breed them in captivity, like in facilities, so when it's safe to go out and reintroduce them, they can then go back and thrive.
Wow. So, Lena, does this harlequin toad possess the answer, the secret to solving the fungus problem?
We don't think so, but that's why you're here, Mark. We're heading tomorrow to the field to try to find the species that might have the solution for the pandemic.
Wow, so we're looking for like the holy grail of harlequin toads.
Yep, another new undescribed species that might have the solution, the key to what we have been looking for so many years.
With sights set on the critical mission to locate one of these extremely rare amphibians, we began our trek into the untamed wilderness of southeastern Ecuador. This is one of many locations around Latin America studied by the Atelopus Survival Initiative and their wide network of field research to uncover scientific information surrounding the outbreak. Today we are hoping to find a critical piece of the puzzle to help them crack the code. And after traveling hundreds of miles, over mountains, through mountains, and to the edge of the Amazon rainforest, we set out on foot and hiked into the unknown. Through the forest, we forged streams, muddy terrain, and endured cold mountain rainstorms that soaked us to the bone. But it would all be worth it if we could be lucky enough to discover one of these scientific treasures.
Wow, this place is unbelievable.
Welcome to the Amazon.
So, Lena, what signs are we looking for to try to spot one of these rare amphibians?
So, harlequin toads do live in the forest, but because we're at the end of the reproductive season, most likely we will see them by the creeks where they are reproducing.
So, how far are we going to hike in there?
We have like 40 minutes, and then we start going down.
Okay.
Rainforests earn their name for a reason. In one of the wettest places on Earth, we search for what seemed like hours without a single glimpse of a toad.
All right, Lena, is this a good spot?
Yeah, let's look under the leaves here by the streams, but also look on top of the leaves up there.
All right.
While we did stumble upon other bizarre inhabitants, I started to lose hope of a successful outcome. But then, almost on cue, the rain subsided, the sun came out, and out of the corner of my eye, I caught a flash of color.
Oh, I think I got one.
Really?
Yep.
Really?
Yeah, hang on. Slow. Got him.
That's the one. Yeah, that's the one. You see that yellow coloration? That's probably a female. What a beauty.
Man. Yes.
Good job.
Woo! Oh my goodness, I can't believe we finally found one. Here, let's set up right here. We got our gloves out. So we want to make sure handling these, we wear gloves, right?
Right, because remember the disease, the fungus? We want to be sure we're not transmitting any diseases. It's mainly to protect them.
Beautiful. Wow.
Isn't that beautiful?
This is the toad we were looking for, right, Lena?
Yeah, this is the toad that we think might have an answer to this epidemic that is affecting harlequin toads.
This harlequin toad, this is a brand new species.
Yes, this is a species that will be described for science.
Wow.
And if you look, the belly is a little bit brighter coloration, and that's how you know it's a female. And you can see the hands and the feet, they have a red, beautiful, bright coloration. And that's why we call them the jewels, because they are decorating the forest and creeks of South America and Central America.
Do you mind if I...
No, go for it.
Oh, I got it. Oh, I love how charismatic these toads are. They have so much personality, just like the way they walk.
They're so elegant and...
They're so proud, the way they stand up on their haunches.
And people tend to think that toads are ugly and big, but look at these.
How many species, known species, of harlequin toad exist?
So known species, there's described 98, but we think there's gonna be around 120 that need to be described like this one.
So that name, Jewel of the Rainforest, it doesn't just represent the beautiful coloration of these toads, it's the rarity. These are extremely rare amphibians. I mean, guys, we've been walking and hiking in this jungle all day long, and we've only seen one.
And you only find them in very, very small places. They're unique and jewels, they're rare.
This environment that we're in now, the fact that we found a toad here means that this is a very pristine environment. This water is almost drinkable.
Right, so harlequin toads are an indicator of water quality. So if you see a harlequin toad in a place like this, it's because most likely this is healthy water.
There's a fairly high likelihood that we are some of the few people that have actually made contact with this species.
Absolutely, you're a lucky man. And as you could see, we had to walk a lot to see it, so it's not a common animal.
The majority of harlequin toad species are endangered.
They're endangered and they're endemic, which means that they're only found in one place.
This species of harlequin toad only resides in the inverse islands of Latin America. Mm-hmm.
If this disappears from this place, we won't have them anywhere else in the world. So that makes them even more threatened.
These harlequin toads are disappearing at an increasing rate.
Yeah, and I hope it's not the case, but we might come in a year and we might not see it again.
So it's very important and timely that we're here today in the rainforest and we found a toad to bring back to Jambatu, because this particular harlequin toad might just hold the secret to the entire species for saving them from this fungus.
If we unlock the secret of why they're surviving, we can use that information to save the rest.
So there's a high likelihood that this harlequin toad that we've found actually does have the fungus right now.
Yep.
How is it possible that this harlequin toad is surviving with the fungus?
Well, the first thing that we need to know is to be sure that it has the fungus.
Got it.
So we will do some swabs, we will collect that information and take it back to the lab to see if it indeed has BD. BD is the scientific name for this deadly disease.
Got it. So hopefully this might be the information they need to develop a vaccine of sorts for this deadly disease.
But it's important to know, Mark, that it's not just the fungus. Also, if we lose this forest, if we pollute this water, It doesn't matter if they have an immunity. We still have to protect the habitat where they live.
Right.
If the world's worst pathogen outbreak wasn't enough, the habitat of these toads and all wildlife in Latin America are under constant threat from pollution, deforestation, strip mining of wild lands, and the global climate crisis in general. The toad we found today will be highly valuable in taking one step closer to finding a cure to BD. But if we don't save the forests, rivers, and streams that make up this beautiful ecosystem, all the effort to save this species will be lost.
In Jambato, we love frogs. Saving frogs is my life's work. Please consider joining the effort to save frogs from extinction with us.
While it is quite possible the harlequin toad featured in this video may never be seen again in the wild, it isn't too late to support programs like Jambato and the Atelopus Survival Initiative that are protecting and breeding these toads in captivity for re-release into the wild once the pandemic is over. Please click the donate button or the link in the description to join Brave Wilderness and rewild.org in supporting their critical work. We must not allow these jewels of the rainforest to disappear without a fight. The time for us to save them is now.